Now Haas has a number of products to help make your rotary system and machining in general much more productive. So many, in fact, that people can get confused. And that's probably what Phil from Alabama had in mind when he wrote this letter.
I recently picked up a Haas HRT 210 rotary table because I have a part that needs multiple setups. Now I know I want to reduce my cycle time and I want to reduce my handling time, but figuring out how to best fixture my part really has me scratching my head.
So Phil, there's a lot of ways to hold a part on a rotary. You could do something really simple, like mount your part directly to the platter face and then use T-nuts and clamps and hold it. But that only works if you're doing one part at a time. Otherwise, every time you change the part, you've got to indicate it in. You could also use a vise, using the T-slots and some T-nuts. And as long as you have a stop, you have a very repeatable setup. But again, you're only doing one part at a time, so it's not ideal. Now here are some of the options that Haas has to offer. Let's start with the quick change system. This system allows you to load and unload easily cubes or plates using this air ratcheting system. And because we have precision locators, that means every time you load your cube or your plate, you can be sure that the location will be spot on every time. Want to put features on all six faces? Machine the first three faces on each part. Stop, flip and rotate each part. Now finish up the three remaining faces. And there you go, four parts, each with all six faces machined. Or let's say you're machining the same part on all four sides with all the same features. So I take off my finished parts. I want to keep the spindle turning as much as possible. So I'm going to unload these later. So let's get rid of those. And now I've got raw material on this one. And I'm ready to go. No machine downtime. Now the quick change plate works the same way, but it allows you to put a larger part or maybe even a bunch of small parts on one or both sides of the plate. So what can you do with it? Well, you could do something like this. You can drill and tap some holes and mount a vise to one side, or as we've done here, if you want to hold a bunch of parts, drill and tap several holes and mount some low profile clamps here. Now, if you have larger parts, you might consider our block system. This is just like the cube, only longer. Now, it's easy to mount. You bolt it directly to the platter, and it's supported by an A-frame. We have a 12-inch and a 20-inch, depending on how long your parts are. Now, this is the 20-inch block. You could, of course, machine the block itself, or mount a vise or multiple vises, maybe one on each side, or mount a whole bunch of parts using those low profile clamps we saw earlier. You could machine all three sides, take the part off, flip them, then machine the remaining three sides. That's a great way to keep your spindle running for a really long time between reloads. And of course, you can always get spare blocks, plates, cubes, everything you need. And because they're made by Haas, you know you're getting quality parts at a fair price. Phil, thanks. That was a great question. And if any of you have questions, send them to me at answerman@haascnc.com. And remember, if you've got questions, I've got the answers. Thanks for watching.